My name is Christof Teuscher. I'm a professor in the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering at Portland State University. So machine learning is, if you go back 50 years or so, the challenge was to build machines that can do things that humans can't do or that humans can do well, like playing chess or something like that, right? These are solved problems. But in those days, machine learning is more about pattern recognition and doing things in a smart and adaptive way, where human intelligence basically fails or basically our brain is too small to solve these problems, right? Maybe a good example is airline reservation systems, where you can't do that as a human. It's just too complex. There's too many variables. There's too many things that you have to consider. So machines are doing that job really, really well. But we're looking at tasks where humans used to be good, like face recognition and things like that, and machines weren't, and that is changing. I think now we have machines that are more reliable at recognizing faces and can do things that we as humans used to be good, but now machines are taking over. So it's a whole new exciting field. We're looking at the what we call the computing stack that goes basically from the hardware, the devices that do the computation, up to the application, as sort of an all-encompassing problem. You can't really solve issues at one of these levels only in these days. It has to really address all the different abstraction levels and the different components that you're going to work with. So it's very interdisciplinary for that specific reason, and it involves computer science, and it involves electrical engineering, but it also involves biology. If you're changing the substrate and are computing with biomolecules instead of transistors, for example. So we're very much interested in using novel types of devices, building computing architectures with those, and then also find new ways of programming them. And very often in these days, we use machine learning as a way to program these systems and make them do things that we cannot do otherwise. So learning, adaptation, these are very interesting properties that we're interested in. And that goes in the direction, the generally hot topic in these days of machine learning and AI and, you know, machines doing things that we as humans are not actually so good at doing. But we also have more exotic things like a biomolecular computation project where the basic building blocks are not transistors or memristors, it's biomolecules, DNA strands that combine, recombine. And so computing with those sorts of things is a whole other level of challenges, and it has applications for biomedical and the biomedical field, smart adaptive devices that you can potentially swallow, wear on your skin, under your skin, that monitor your blood sugar, whatever it is. So there's lots of really cool applications in the biomedical field, where you need machines that adapt, that learn, that adapt to your lifestyle, for example. And that's another research axis as an example. Moving into no man's land, high risk, high payoff. That's, I would say, is the summary of the research that we're doing. If things work, great, but there's high risk, and many of the avenues that we're exploring may not work. But that's part of research. It's never a straight line, and we really have to explore that no man's land to find out, well, what is a potential avenue forward. My name is Christof Teuscher. Our research purpose is to build smarter and better computers to make this a better world.